How are you doing?
Well, how are you?
Okay, so is it, I don't know, harder when you're doing the movie or when it's getting ready to go out there and the anticipation's built up? And
well, you know what's amazing is that can be incredibly hard. And actually, I haven't had that problem here. It's so funny because this movie, we were working up to the last minute. So actually, I only finished the movie about a good week or maybe close to 10 days ago. Because if you were actually sitting for months, you would probably just keel from anticipation. Yeah. No. So actually, this is perfect because I just today was like, yeah, I think we're actually premiering the movie tonight. So
what took you so long to finish it up? That's cutting it really close.
It's close. Well, it's what's in the movie. We've got so much going on in terms of all of our effects work and so much that we wanted to get into the movie. And I'm a bit of a perfectionist. So we worked up to the wire, but I'm really thrilled with the results.
When you're a perfectionist, is it harder then to allow your cast to improv because you want them?
Oh, no, just the opposite. Because, I mean, again, the life of the movie, for me, the job, especially on a film like this, is make sure that I create an environment where they get to actually play and not have them get overwhelmed by effects, not have them get overwhelmed by the set. If anything, it's more like, selfishly, I want to go back to that cutting room later when I'm done and have just this wealth of material from, I mean, Will and Danny are such genius improvers. So no, that's the fun part.
How tough was it to make a movie that people who've never heard of Land of the Lost are going to get, but yet the fans of the original are also going to get into?
Well, in a way, the fans I didn't worry about because I was such a consummate fan. Will was such a consummate fan. And I was pitching stuff that I wanted to bring into the movie that even Sid Marty Crawford, like, wow, we forgot about that. So I knew I'd have that covered, but you have to approach it assuming that basically people aren't going to all know it, and that's fine. And that's where we wanted to go make a comedy that could just stand on its own with a tremendous, crazy spectacle and psychedelic kind of feel, and let it be that too.
Excellent. Yeah. Last question, what's happening with the next Lemony Snickets? Are you going to do it?
It's been this exciting question the last few days. I know there's such a really incredible desire to get to do it, and I know Mr. Handler, who was a friend of Mr. Snicket's, would love to see it happen too. So, you know, now that the studios have sort of resolved themselves, hopefully it'll happen.